On the 11th of June 2018, the England men's football team lost 2-1 against Croatia in the Football World Cup semi-final, leaving both the team and the nation heartbroken.
However, on the 14th of July 2019, the England cricket team stepped up to the occasion and succeeded where the football team didn't, in what can only be described as one of, if not the best game of cricket history has ever seen. The final was to be played at Lord's, the home of cricket, and even though there was a bit of rain in the morning, adding more movement to the wicket and giving the advantage to the bowling side, New Zealand captain Kane Williamson chose to bat after winning the toss.
Due to pitch conditions, the England bowlers had a great start, with Woakes taking an early wicket to Gupta, with New Zealand only having 35 runs on the board. However, due to the batting of Captain Williamson, who to this point hadn't failed to disappoint during the competition, an opener Nichols, the next wicket of Williamson, caught behind by Butler and bowled by Plunkett, would not come till the 103rd run, four balls into the 22nd over, and made the likelihood of a Kiwi win more of a possibility. But England would not stand for that, and after the second wicket, England took a steady flow of wickets all the way to the 50th over, leaving a very achievable target to see an England win.
Even with a very achievable score on the board set from New Zealand, the opening England batsmen failed to find their rhythm, being 86 for 4 come the 24th over. All hope seemed lost, until the dream pairing of Ben Stokes and Joss Butler managed to build up a partnership of a game-saving 110 runs. After the fall of Butler, the pressure seemed to get to the remaining batsmen, not putting that much on the board, until England were 8 down and needing 15 runs to win off their final over. It would have been 21 runs off the final over, however, if not for a miraculous step over the boundary, which granted Stokes with a miracle 6, which wouldn't be the only miracle 6 in this match. It was 9 from 3, a desperate effort from Stokes. He ran for one, he came back for the second, and well, I can only show you what happened next.
Oh, he gets in the way! This has got to go all the way to the boundary off the bat! Can you believe this? It has! I do not believe what I've just seen!
After a desperate final over, it left one ball left, needing 2 runs. They ran for one, coming back for the second. However, even though he tried his best, Wood could not get back and was ran out, leading to what was the first ever super over seen in an international cricket tournament. It was obvious who was going to bat in the super over. Butler, first choice of course, and a reluctant Ben Stokes going back onto the field in hopes of granting England the win. With an extraordinary effort from Butler and Stokes, with an extraordinary 4 on the final ball, they left New Zealand with 16 to win off the final over, making it still anybody's game. Disaster struck on the first ball with Archer bowling a wide, granting New Zealand not only with a run, but an extra ball in the over. What were England going to do? Morgan had only one plan, put all his players on the boundary, making it very easy for New Zealand to get cheeky singles, but extremely difficult to come back for any more than that. The game couldn't be any closer, New Zealand needing 2 runs off the final ball. It was all down to Guptill. Archer bowls it. Guptill smashes it into the field, straight to an England fielder. They come back for a second. It's thrown to Butler.
He's got it! England have won the World Cup by the barest of margins! By the barest of all margins! Absolute ecstasy for England!
A momentous occasion. The first ODI World Cup won by England. It couldn't have been any closer.
With England only winning the game due to them having more boundaries during the match, that day of all days, luck was definitely in England's favour.
I heard a dark voice beside of me, and I looked round in a state of fright. I saw four faces, one man, a brother from the gutter. They looked me up and down a bit and turned to each other.